Hi, let's talk about the eye. In this video, we'll discuss the basic layers and supporting apparatus of the eye and its various components. The eye can be thought of as a structure consisting of three layers surrounding an inner part. The three layers, or sometimes tunics as they're called, are the fibrous layer, which is the outermost layer of the eye, which provides structural support. The vascular layer, or the uvea, which is the middle layer that conducts vasculature and helps to transmit and refract light. And then the inner nervous layer, also known as the retina, which contains the special sensory receptors for light, which enable vision. These layers surround the inner part, which consists of the lens, or a lens, which separates two chambers, an anterior chamber that contains aqueous humor, and a posterior chamber, which contains vitreous humor. The fibrous layer, or that outermost structural layer, consists of a sclera and a cornea. The sclera is found in the posterior 4/5 of the eye, often referred to as the white of the eye. So General Putnam of the Continental Army likely apocryphally said, don't fire until you see the whites of their eyes, preceding the Battle of Bunker Hill. So Putnam was referring to their sclera of the British regulars. This is an important site, not just to give structure to the eye, but it also is where the extraocular muscles, or the extrinsic eye muscles, are going to insert upon the eye so that they can exert force upon it to move the eye. Anteriorly, the cornea is a transparent layer that is completely avascular, but is not without its nerve ending. So it's very sensitive to touch. And it is the main refractive index for light as it enters into the eye. Deeper to the fibrous layer is the vascular layer, also known as the uvea. The vascular layer has many different parts to it. The part that is most abundantly clear to the observer is the pigmented iris of the eye. The iris is a diaphragm which is adjustable to either let more light into the eye during a sympathetic response, so the dilator pupillae will contract and the pupil, which is the hole through the iris, expands, or during a parasympathetic response, the sphincter pupillae muscles will contract and that pupil will constrict. There are also ciliary bodies. These ciliary bodies are not visible from the outside. We can see them here in this sagittal section. The ciliary body are what anchors the lens in place, as we can see there. The ciliary body will also contain ciliary muscle, which is smooth muscle, which activates for the purpose of accommodation or reshaping the lens. That ciliary body is what secretes the aqueous humor into the anterior chamber, and it also secretes components of the vitreous humor into the posterior chamber. In addition to the iris and the ciliary body, there's also a choroid layer. The choroid layer sits between the sclera and the retina, and it is very richly vascular. The innermost layer, or the nervous layer, is the retina. So this layer is a varied layer. There are approximately 10 layers of very specialized cells, including special sensory receptors for light. These include both rods and cones, as well as retinal ganglion cells and various other cells. It's those retinal ganglion cells that are going to exit the eye as the optic nerve. Bundled within the optic nerve is a branch of the ophthalmic artery known as the central retinal artery. So this is within the dural sheath of the optic nerve. Here in this fundoscope, we can actually see some of these branches of the central retinal artery spread out amongst the retina. So we've discussed the eye and its three layers, fibrous, vascular, and nervous, as well as its inner part as well. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.